Hi friends, welcome to EduTabs. So welcome to this Everyday at 5 series for IBPS AFO 2018-19. So friends, let me just tell you what this series is all about. So starting from today, every day at 5 p.m. you shall be getting a lecture that is based upon a small concept based on agriculture, right? And this is going to be a regular series wherein we shall be taking a variety of topics from various chapters in agriculture. It is specifically designed for IBPS AFO 2018-19 examination, and what we shall do is we shall keep this series interactive, wherein I shall be putting forth a lot of questions in between, and we can discuss those questions in the next day lecture, right? So here in the first week, what we shall do is we shall discuss three crops altogether, right? Like today's lecture will contain five questions on the crop apple, right? And when we are coming out with lecture two, we shall discuss some of the other characteristics. So when you study lecture one and lecture two, your preparation for this particular crop will be done, right? So we really need your participation here, because the questions that we'll be putting forth today, we can you can try and come out with answers. Mention those answers in the comment section below, and tomorrow we shall discuss that, right? Fine. So the first question being, name the climatic region of apple fruit. So basically, there are various climatic zones when you talk about cultivating crops. Okay. So there is subtropical, temperate, and tropical. So there is one other zone which is known as polar region. But this region does not have a suitable climatic condition for the crops to be grown there. So we are eliminating this region when it comes to the climatic zones for horticulture crops. Right? So the answer for this particular question is temperate. So kindly note this particular point. Now here comes my first question. What is the optimum temperature that is required for the apple to grow, apple plant to grow? Right? So the first question from our end for this particular lecture is the optimum temperature requirement. Kindly mention the range in the comment section given below. So here you can see that the entire world map, you can see it is divided into various temperature zones. So near the equator, from 0 to 23.5 degree north, you can see this part is a tropical zone, right? And you can see that the southern part of India lies in this particular zone. Then as you move forward, 23.5 to nearly 40 would fall under subtropical. And you can see that the northern part of India falls in this particular zone. Then you have till 66.5, which is the temperate zone. And finally, you have the polar zone, right? Okay, so the second question out here, which of the following is the propagation method of apple? So when you talk about propagation, it is nothing but you are cultivating a new plant, okay, by using the various parts of a plant. Okay, the parts that can be used can range from stem, it can be leaves, okay, it can be roots, it can be seeds, fine. And based upon what mode is followed, you can divide this propagation methods into sexual and asexual. Okay, when you talk about asexual propagation methods, which are very common in plants because it takes lesser time when compared to sexual methods, this is also known as vegetative propagation. Now, why is it called vegetative propagation? Because you are using those parts or the vegetative parts of the plant for propagation. For example, stems, leaves. Okay, so when you use these parts and you produce a new plant, then you called it as vegetative propagation, right? So there is the reproductive parts of the plant as well, which is the flower. Okay, so when you have a plant which is formed or germinated from seed, then that particular method is known as sexual method of propagation or sexual method of reproduction, right? So here you can see that because of the presence of male and female gametes through pollination, okay, you have seeds that are formed, and when these seeds are sown in the ground, you get a new plant. So this usual method is referred to the normal sexual method, but here we are talking about the vegetative propagation. So the common vegetative propagation methods are budding and grafting. Okay, so the answer for this particular question is going to be shield budding. Okay, just mark this, this is important. Now there is second question that I'm going to put forth for you guys today, that under budding we have seen the example to be shield budding. So which kind of grafting method is suitable when it comes to propagation of apple, right? So now you have to tell me which is that grafting method, okay? So the first question was regarding the optimum temperature which the apple requires for its growth, and second is the grafting method which is used for its propagation, right? Okay, so the third question out here, for optimum growth and fruiting, apple tree needs rainfall in how much, or what is the requirement of rainfall in mm, right? Now the answer to this question is 1000 to 1200. So kindly memorize this. This is annual requirement. Okay, sorry, yeah, annual requirement. Okay, so the fourth question out here, for seedling preparation, what is the size of pit? Okay, in the case of apple. Okay, now the answer to this question is 1 meter into 1 meter into 1 meter. So you need to dig in a bit and form a certain base on which the seedling can be planted or grown, so that you construct a pit, and the size of the pit is important. Okay, the depth matters. So this is the particular depth that is required in the case of apple. Now here's the third question for today, that what is the planting space that is required when apples are cultivated? Now when you talk about planting space, you need to understand that whenever you are cultivating a particular tree or a crop, so here there is a spacing which is called row to row spacing and plant to plant spacing. Okay, so here you can see that these are rows. Okay, so you are measuring what is the row to row spacing, and these are plants. So when you try and see what is the space between each individual plant, then you say plant to plant spacing. So you need to tell me what is the plant planting space that is required in the case of cultivating apples. Okay, this is the third question. Okay, so the fifth question for discussion today, which of the following is a hybrid variety of apple? So a straightforward question, but you can answer this only when you are aware of the hybrid varieties of many crops, because these are quite confusing options. So the answer for this particular question is Sunheri. So kindly mark this particular answer. Okay, so now you need to tell me. Okay, so the next question that I'm putting forth today is, name two other important hybrid varieties of apple. Okay, so this is something you need to answer. So let me just say what are the questions that we need to discuss. One is the optimum temperature which the crop requires. Second is which grafting method is used when apples are, which grafting method is used for the propagation of apple. We have discussed budding method, which is shield budding. The third one is what is the planting space, okay, that is row into row and plant into plant spacing. We have seen the pit size also. The next question is, name two varieties of hybrid varieties, in fact, of apple. We have seen one hybrid variety, that is Sunheri, right? So these are the answers for the questions we have just discussed. So friends, if you have any query, you can kindly drop us a mail at hello@edutab.co.in. If you want to know more about our courses, you can visit our website at www.edutab.co.in, or you can also give us a call at 814-620-7241. So friends, these are some of the courses that EduTap is offering for IBPS AFO 2018-19. So we have a full video course for it. And this particular course would contain the videos, the content sheets, summary sheets, worksheet and MCQs for each of the chapters of agriculture. And for the first 100 subscribers, we are offering at a price of ₹2499. And we are also offering a test series. There are 25 sectional tests and 25 mock tests. And this test series is also a part of the full video course. If you want to avail separately the test series, that is also available. So that can be availed at a price of ₹1499. So friends, with this, we have come to the end of this particular video today. So kindly give us the answers for the four questions that we had put forth. So only by your responses, we'll be able to judge how much the series is going to help you out. And if you want to download the PDF of this particular video, you can do so by going to EduTap's Telegram channel. The link for the channel is placed on your screens. Plus, you can find the link in the description box of this video as well. Now, if you really found this video useful, kindly like, subscribe and share. Till then, friends, thank you so much and happy learning.